Is anyone else like that, where like you want to have a career in social media, but you don't like being on social media for too long?
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. You probably can't even hear me, and I'm so sorry for that. It's 7 a.m. in the morning. I am at my boyfriend's house. We just got in from the Bay to LA last night at like, I don't know, 7 p.m. I did not wash my face last night. I was so tired, and he was taking forever in the bathroom when I was ready to do my makeup. I mean, I'm so tired when I was ready to do my skincare. But I don't know, I just woke up feeling kind of like calm but gloomy. So we're gonna get dressed. We're gonna go to the gym, get some sleep in it, get my dopamine to my endorphins up. Then we're gonna do my morning routine and then get some stuff done because I wanna upload a YouTube video today. I kind of want to apply to some modeling agencies, and maybe create some content. I feel like I've been in content creating work, so I don't know if you can hear me. This might be pointless, but maybe I can put captions down at the bottom or something, but I'm tired.
I literally had to be so silent because my boyfriend is on the bed that takes away. My boyfriend is a he likes to sleep in late, and so I could just see me like waking him up every movement that I made, and it was not fun at all.
Alright, I made it in the car. So let's have a little chat before we go to the gym. I'm gonna go to the gym. I go to Anytime Fitness, so I'm just gonna go to an Anytime Fitness around here. Probably the same one that I always go to. Hopefully it is quiet and hopefully there is no one there. But yeah, I kinda just wanna have a little chat. Can I prop this up somewhere? My camera is on the way, so it's not here yet. I don't want to prop it up there because it doesn't look good. It's okay. I'll just hold it with my hand. But yeah, what I was saying, if you couldn't hear me in the bathroom, was that like, lock the doors. I woke up feeling really calm, but like a little like gloomy. I mean, the weather is literally gloomy because that's how it always is over here. Not always, but like in the morning because it's like right near the beach. But yeah, I woke up feeling a little gloom, not sad or anything, just like calm and like kind of neutral, but gloom neutral, if that makes sense. You ever wake up like that? But I was just like, okay. I mean, I did go to sleep abruptly. I really wanted to wash my face. I didn't wash my face. I'm low-key pissed, but you know, it's fine. But you know, I woke up early. I'm gonna go to the gym, get my workout in, get my endorphins and like dopamine up. I hope that is correct. When you say it with enough confidence, it is. But yeah, and then we'll have a little chat because I don't know. I have been feeling like I've been in a social media creative rut, like especially with like TikTok and Instagram. I'm really leaning more towards YouTube. I feel like I like long form videos and like chatting. I don't know. It's like I want to grow, but also like I want to be authentic to myself. And is anyone else like that, where like you want to have a career in social media, but you don't like being on social media for too long? I feel like you're susceptible to like a lot of energies, a lot of thoughts and perspectives that like you don't need to listen to, especially if your mindset isn't in like a strong place, or just if you're easily susceptible to taking in other people's energies. And I am definitely someone who's very the way my body type is, I take in people's energies very quickly. So I have to like set intentions before going on social media, or just be very aware of like my energetic mood before I get on versus after, because I need to understand if it's my energy or someone else's. Like, am I triggered by something, or am I just overthinking it? Virgo placements. So yeah. Anyways, I'm not overthinking anything right now, so I'm just gonna head to the gym. I won't be able to take you all along with me because I am recording on my phone. My camera is on the way. But for now, we're gonna be using this. So I'll talk to you guys when I get to the gym. And then yeah, let's go. Alright, so we're at the gym. I just pulled up and it is leg day. It's leg day. It's leg day. So we're gonna do a little bit of legs, do a little bit of yoga, and call it a day because that's all I have on my list, actually. I'm not even tired. That's just all I have on my list. So let's get this body moving. Maybe I'll do a little bit of cardio. No, I'll probably just do yoga. I'll probably go for a walk on the beach later today. So let's go, mate. Not this person just putting their freaking headphones in like my little cubby area. I was like, whose is this? Oh my gosh, 444. 444 right next to me, angels. Let me get in the car. Yeah. Someone just put like, fix the lighting. Someone just put their AirPods, like, not even AirPods, their earphones in my little cubby where my stuff was at. I came back from the bathroom like, whose is this? It's fine, we're out of the gym. It was a great little sesh. I did legs. Lately I've been doing like three exercises and three exercises only, because my focus is like mobility and losing fat right now. So I do strength training 3 weeks. I can't even talk. I do strength training 3 days out of the week, and then the other days are like cardio and yoga. So I'm gonna do some yoga when I get back to my boyfriend's place, and then probably go grab some breakfast, because we don't have any breakfast because we just got in last night, and he was gone for like 2 weeks or so, two, 3 weeks. So let's go back to his house. Brown sugar, babe, I kiss her off of love, don't know how to behave. Hey babe, so I totally forgot to vlog like the rest of my day. How come? Where's the lighting? Here we go. Where's the lighting? I can't find the lighting. Anyways, so I totally forgot to vlog my day yesterday. What did I end up doing? I made breakfast after the gym, and then me and my boyfriend did some work. I uploaded a YouTube video. Like I said, it's just kind of challenging to record some of those things when like I use my phone and like I need my phone. So I wasn't able to record any of that. But my boyfriend is getting me some water because I need some agua. Sorry. I just want this to look good. Anyways, my boyfriend's getting me some water right now. We're gonna go to Dover Street Market, and then not that little fly being in here. Can you scattle? Let's not even talk about that, okay? I'm trying not to kill bugs, but like there are some bugs that like, you know, you just have to kill. But anyways, yeah, so we're gonna go over to Dover Street Market, do a little bit of shopping. He said he was gonna get me something, so. And then I have a half birthday dinner for my friend. So we're gonna head over to downtown because they live in like one of the downtown apartments over there. So we're gonna head downtown for that, and it's just gonna be me going to this half birthday soirée. It's like a dinner, Mediterranean. The invitation was so cute. But yes, so we're gonna head there, and it's gonna be a really fun time. I'll try to get some recording. This is gonna be like, I haven't really vlogged, you know, like around other people. This is my first time really vlogging, so I'm a little nervous. Also, details, I'm wearing this. You can't even see, my arm's about to fall off from holding this, but I'm wearing a Aritzia dress. My lips are NYX and I don't know, this like gloss. And then my eyeshadow is Kylie's You're So Money palette. You're So Money, baby. And brows are Anastasia. Mascara is Telescopic L'Oreal, or L'Oreal. And I just have a little bit of concealer under my eye. LA girl. LA girl cosmetics. So let's go. Isn't he so LA? He got me Evian. You're so LA, babe. Myself then. We've got my Evian water, spring water. We only do spring water around here. At least we try. I'm glad you got the memo. Ah! Don't tickle me! We're in LA, everyone! Let me in, so I'm like, where am I going? Fuck. So I made it to the rooftop. It was actually the building across the street, but we're here and it's cold. Luckily, they're gonna bring me a blanket. It looks so cute. I'm not looking at the camera. Sorry, I'm getting used to this. It looks so cute. I'm so excited. It's actually not even that cold right now. But yeah, I'm very excited. The views are so cute and yeah, it's a little bit good vibe. Hello everybody. Yeah, I'm ready. So we're about to go to Dover Street Market because we didn't go yesterday because it closed. We did go to Bodega, which I did record. But we're gonna go to Dover Street Market and then grocery shopping and then something else that I don't know if I want to share with you all just yet. So get in. What'd you say? Okay, can we talk about my hair for a quick second? This is where I long to be, La Isla Bonita. So I'm in the bathroom here at Dover Street. Look at this toilet, okay? what the fuck? Where are all these things, bro? I've never seen this before in my life. We just got back. It's been hours, but I can't wait to show you guys the glasses that he got me. They're so cute. We're gonna eat, so hopefully I will show you the glasses today, if not tomorrow. I need to eat though and help him put the groceries away because we're both very tired and very hungry. Hey everyone, I hope the lighting is good. But good morning. It is Monday, October 2nd. I just woke up and I woke up feeling tired, and then immediately I went on my phone and that was not the best idea. I normally go on my phone to check if anyone, check my engagement, which is not the best habit. I don't do it all the time, but it's not the best habit personally to check your phone right in the morning, before you've gotten your vibe right and gotten on your high flying disc and just really set up your vibe and mood for the day. But I did it, and I saw this TikTok video of this girl who grew to 40,000 followers in 2 months, and subconsciously I started to compare myself and my journey, and it was more so coming from a place of, oh my gosh, what did she do so I can do that too? Because you know, when you really desire something, you also would love for it to come quickly. They just come hand in hand. We love instant gratification. I found myself scrolling through her videos. I think her name is Justine's camera roll. Anyways, and I like the girl so far from what I see. So it wasn't oh my gosh, what are you doing? And blah, blah, blah. It was more oh my gosh, what are you doing? I want to see what you're doing so I can implement that. But it was coming from a place of lack and desperation almost. And more so of a place of what am I doing wrong? It was coming from a place of, I'm the problem, I'm doing something wrong. And that's never the right energy to be in, because it's a negative energy to be in. So then I checked myself. I got off my phone. I meditated for 15 minutes. I listened to a frequency, 777 hertz, I believe. I just keep seeing 777. So when I saw it on my YouTube page, the second one, I was okay, I'm just gonna do that one. And it was a bit challenging, I won't even front, but it was helpful. Also, please excuse my appearance. I don't know why I'm saying excuse my appearance, but this is how I look. But I literally just woke up, haven't brushed my teeth, haven't washed my face, nothing, because sometimes it'd be like that. And this is the real. Yeah, I meditated for 15 minutes and then I just journaled. So here's my journal. I already feel so much better. And then, I don't know, the thought just came, why don't you record this? This is the real. This is real stuff that people don't see on Instagram, on your Instagram story, on TikTok. They don't see this side of living, the side that isn't super upbeat, or should I say the side of me that isn't super upbeat and happy and joyful and everything's gonna work out. You know, there are moments when, as a human being, you feel a little low. We live by the airport, so that's the airplane. But yeah, there are moments when you don't feel your best, and I just feel like I should document it. One, because I know I'm not the only one who does this. I know, regardless if you want to be a content creator, a YouTuber, a doctor, a fashion designer, whatever you want to be, there's always a part of you that will compare yourself to another person's journey. And I just feel like it's important. A throat chakra, who's trying to prevent this from coming out. I just feel like it's important to share these times so that on a human level, we all know that we go through similar things and it's okay. It's okay. And there are ways to, you know, get yourself out of those moods, out of those times. So I just wanted to share, get a little closer with you all, get more personal. This is the type of stuff that I don't get to share all the time, or that I choose not to share. And if you're listening, God and the universe is always guiding you. And something told me to pull out my phone and record this right now. So that's what I'm doing. Bonnet and all. Again, face not washed, eyebrows looking how they look. Like, actually, I look pretty good to like not have washed my face. But anyways, we don't have to go there. But yeah, so if you are listening to this and you notice that this happens to you quite a bit, I would say do your best to not get triggered in the morning, whether that's staying off your phone, whether that's not speaking to certain people, because certain people have, like, there are certain people who will have conversations with you about a certain topic that, like, you're just not prepared for in the morning. So save that for later. Maybe don't text certain people back, or don't even text back in the morning. Whatever you need to do to keep your vibe right in the morning, because that is the prime time. Like, that's the perfect time to establish what vibe you're going to be in for the rest of the day. You can't control everything else that happens later in the day, but you can control your vibe in the morning. And that is what I just did. Shout out to Abraham Hicks. Love you. And I feel so much better already. So I'm going to get up, get some water in my system, some more water, get some food, and get some movement in, because that's going to make me feel good. And as much as, like, my body feels like, you know how, like, I'm going on a little tangent, but I don't care. You know how, like, as human beings, we have, like, these fight or flight modes? Well, we were created to have those in times of, like, actual need, like survival. And now we have them for different things. Like, right now, my body feels a type of urgency to create content. I feel like it is urgent that I do that now. Otherwise, I'm not going to be successful. It's not going to happen. And that is just not true. I have to remind myself that it's okay, Munira. You can take your time. Get yourself in the right vibration before you decide to create this content. But my body is like, oh my gosh, if you don't do this, you're not going to be successful. Like, what if you're missing out on something? And it's all from, like, a place of lack. When I feel like the best comes from when you're in the best state, when you're in the best energy, when you're in the best frequency, the things that last the longest, the most sustainable things, the most valuable things come from when you are in a high vibration, when you are in an abundant mindset. So I'm not going to listen to this fake urgency that's in my body, because even though my body feels like that, it's coming from fear and not from passion or inspiration. It's coming from fear and lack. And I'm not listening to that. I'm not. So I'm gonna get up. I'm gonna get my day started on the right foot. And I will not stress myself out about someone else's journey, because that has nothing to do with me. I love you all. I will see you a little later. You all can hear me, because it's pretty windy and I'm right by the beach. Anyway, I decided to get some sun and go to the beach because I was feeling rather gloomy. Well, I've already explained as to why, but I just really wanted to get outside. I noticed whenever I get outside, even for like 5-10 minutes, I feel significantly better. And luckily my boyfriend lives right next to the beach. So I just took a walk over here. Wanted to get some movement in. Didn't feel like jogging. Maybe I should have jogged, but I didn't. Working on getting my 10,000 steps in. I'm on like 3,000, so. But it's just crazy what, it's crazy how grounding nature is. And that seems like something that's so obvious, but sometimes it isn't because of, you know, the world we have constructed over hundreds and hundreds of years. Nature is the most grounding thing there is in this world. And this morning I wasn't feeling super grounded. And now that I'm outside, I'm reminded of, you know, what's important and where I am. And I'm reminded that I have time, that I'm allowed to take a break and come back to myself and come back to this world, this human experience. Like I said, I'm just reminded that I can take a moment for me. But yeah, I just wanted to tap in. I hope everyone's doing well. If you've been feeling anxious or ungrounded, definitely get outside and get some sun. Go touch grass. Like, for real, we say that as a joke, but for real, go touch grass. You may not be privileged enough to have a beach a mile away from you, but there's grass somewhere, there's trees, there's a park. There's some type of body of water, I hope. So get outside, get your body movement. I can't even speak, get your body moving. Clear your mind and remember where you are. Come back to yourself. Just arrived at Bossa Nova. Bossa Nova. Oh, thank you. Bossa Nova. Babe. Hi, baby. Yeah, I like to see your smile. See that M, and that M, and that M? That stands for me, Munia. Yeah.